Yes, they are Carolina based in Long Island, New York. They are not very big and they are not very many, but they are there. These bays are very important because they can be used to determine the time of emplacement of the Carolina Bays. Long Island was created by accumulations of rock debris called moraines deposited by advancing glaciers during the Ice Age. Since the Carolina Bays are found on top of these moraines, we can estimate the maximum age of the bays. A LiDAR image of Long Island, New York shows several areas with Carolina Bays identified by Michael Davias. You can find the link to the Carolina Bay LiDAR visualization tool in the video description below. Carolina Bays in Long Island are difficult to spot because the island is heavily urbanized and many of the bays have been obliterated by human structures. The Carolina Bays that still remain in Long Island are in terrain that is not suitable for construction. Careful inspection reveals the regular structures with raised rims, some of which measure 211 meters in diameter. Most of the Carolina Bays in Long Island are on sandy soil deposited along channels that carried water from the melting glaciers. LiDAR images are necessary to spot the circular to elliptical shapes of the bays with raised rims. This image shows several small Carolina Bays near New York State Route 27. One bay measures 139 meters in diameter, which would be able to fit several houses from the nearby neighborhood. A football field could easily fit within a Carolina Bay with a length of 130 meters. This image shows a circular structure on the grounds of the Brookhaven National Laboratory. This is a particle accelerator that propels elementary particles such as electrons or protons to very high energies around the circular track for colliding beam and fixed target experiments. We will use a map from the U.S. Geological Survey that marks the location of the terminal moraines for our analysis. But first, we need to identify the location of the Carolina Bays by adding a layer with the LiDAR image over the map. On a third layer, we draw red circles to mark the areas with Carolina Bays, and then we remove the LiDAR image. We now have a USGS map with the location of the Carolina Bays. We will come back to this map later. First, we highlight an older southerly deposit called the Ronconcoma Moraine, which formed during the early part of the Wisconsin Stage 4 of the Pleistocene epoch prior to about 55,000 years ago. The Ronconcoma Moraine forms most of the low rolling hills along the east-to-west transect generally on the south side of the Long Island Expressway. The younger, more northerly moraine ridge is called the Harbor Hill Moraine. This was the most recent advance, or Stage 2, of Wisconsin Glacier, which reached its most southward advance about 18,000 years ago. This glacier completely melted in the New York City region approximately 13,000 to 12,000 years ago. We now come back to the map with the locations of the Carolina Bays, and we notice that the bays overlay the Ronconcoma Moraine that was emplaced about 55,000 years ago. From the geological law of superposition, this means that if all the Carolina Bays were emplaced contemporaneously, they are younger than 55,000 years, but it is more likely that the Carolina Bays were emplaced 12,900 years ago at the time of the Younger Dryas cataclysm. The glacier ice impact hypothesis published in 2017 proposes that an extraterrestrial impact on the Laurentide ice sheet ejected glacier ice boulders in ballistic trajectories. The oblique secondary impacts of glacier ice liquefied the ground and created inclined conical cavities that became shallow depressions through viscous relaxation. The saturation bombardment of glacier ice chunks that created the Carolina Bays was made by impacts with energy of 13 kilotons to 3 megatons. There was no place to hide, and the emplacement of the bays has to be associated with an extinction event such as the extinction of the megafauna 12,900 years ago. The extraterrestrial impact also was the trigger for the onset of the Younger Dryas cooling event that lasted 1,300 years. Geological evidence guides the research. Please subscribe to be notified of future videos about the Carolina Bays.